Hi, this is Ross Shain with Boris FX. In this quick tip video, we'll use Mocha Pro running inside Silhouette to produce an unwarped, stabilized output driven by PowerMesh tracking. For this shot, we want to do some paint retouching and have the strokes follow the organic motion of the skin. While Silhouette includes built-in Mocha tracking to drive rotor shapes and linked paint strokes, in this video, we'll be focusing on Mocha Pro's PowerMesh workflow for sub-planar tracking and warp stabilization. We'll start by applying the Mocha Pro OFX plugin to our effects tree. Then we'll launch the interface. We'll create a spline shape around the area that we want to track, and in the tracking tab, we'll enable perspective and mesh tracking. Instead of using the automatic grid mode, I find that uniform grid produces good results for skin. Let's increase the mesh size to 32 and then select Generate Mesh. Before tracking, let's look at the smoothness parameter. Increasing smoothness when mesh tracking will use more of the overall planar track. Decreasing the smoothness will capture more of the organic subplanar warping and is good for surfaces that are more flexible. In this case, we'll enable auto smoothness to let Mocha figure out the best setting. Let's track forwards. After tracking, we can hide the mesh and focus on the points to evaluate the tracking accuracy. If we want to adjust or correct our vertices points, we can enable the Edit Mesh tool and select, add, or delete the mesh points. With the point selected and our zoom window enabled, we can see how accurate each point is and even add adjustment keyframes. If we're happy with our mesh track, we'll go to the Stabilize tab and enable Mesh Warp set to unwarp. Typically, I like to hide our overlays here so we can focus on the result. We can scrub through the timeline and see that the organic motion has been stabilized. If we want to isolate the pixels, we can turn on Use Matte. And here we can add a reference frame to fix the stabilization to a specific frame number. Let's save and close Mocha. Here under Module Renders, we can choose Stabilize Unwarp and Enable Render. Now we can apply any Silhouette node to this stabilized view. We'll apply a paint node and select the clone brush. Silhouette's paint node has a powerful detail separation workflow. We can choose to paint a normal stroke or only paint using the separated detail or color channels. We can view the separated views here in the view pulldown or using shortcut key 8 for color and 9 for detail. We'll clone paint only in the color channel to keep the skin details, but fix these blemishes. Once I'm happy with our paint, we can select all the strokes and run the auto paint mode to apply the strokes across the clip. Now that we've painted on the stabilized area, we can introduce the warp motion back in. We can copy and paste the Mocha Pro node and apply it after our paint node. And now we can simply switch the render to stabilize warp to reapply the original motion. Finally, let's add a composite node to channel the paint fixes back onto the original clip. I'll make sure to select the first Mocha node and enable Apply Matte to channel the alpha through the comp. Or we could go back to the Mocha interface and copy the Mocha shape to the Silhouette Roto format. We can apply a Roto node and paste to convert the track Mocha shape into a native Silhouette Roto layer. As you can see, running the Mocha Pro plugin inside Silhouette with PowerMesh gives effects artists advanced options for all kinds of paint and effects work. For more training videos, please visit us at borisfx.com.